Good day all. I'm Dr. T. Arunmuri, Assistant Professor and Head, Department of Commerce, KCS Kasinadar College of Arts and Science. I welcome you all for the presentation on public issue management relating to pre-issue activities for the subject Merchant Banking and Financial Services. It is based on the curriculum of all universities in this subject. What is pre-issue activities? There are several activities that have to be performed by the issue manager in order to raise money from the capital market. These activities may be called as pre-issue activities. Adequate planning needs to be done while chalking out an appropriate marketing strategy. An analytical study of various sources, the quantum, the appropriate time, the cost of raising capital, and the possible impact of such resources on the overall capital structure will greatly help this task. The various activities involved in raising funds from the capital market are described as Memorandum of Understanding, signing of a Memorandum of Understanding between the client company and the merchant banker. Issue management activities marks the award of the contract. The role and responsibility of the merchant banker as against the issuing company are clearly spelt out in the Memorandum of Understanding. Next, obtaining an appraisal note. An appraisal note containing the details of the proposed capital, outlay of the project, and the sources of funding is either prepared in-house or obtained from external appraising agencies, that is, financial institutions or banks. A project may be funded either by borrowing money from outside agencies or by injecting capital. Third, determining optimum capital structure. The level of the capital that would maximize the shareholders' views, values, and minimize the overall cost of capital has to be determined. This has to be done considering the nature and size of the project. Equity funding is preferable, especially when the project is capital intensive. Fourth one, convening board meeting. A meeting of the board of directors of the issuing company is convened, that is followed by an EGM of its members. The purpose of these meetings is to decide the various aspects related to the issue of securities. An application to RBI seeking its permission is made where capital issue of shares is to be offered to NRIs or FII. Fifth one, appointment of financial intermediary. Financial intermediaries such as underwriter, registrars, etc. have to be appointed. Necessary contract need to be made with the underwriter to ensure due subscription to the offer. Similar contracts, when entered into with the registrars to an issue, will help in share allotment related work, appointment of bankers to an issue for handling the collection of applications at various centers, printers for bulk printing of issue related stationery, legal advisors, and advertising agency. Simultaneously, consents from various experts such as auditors, solicitors, legal advisors, etc. has to be obtained under Section 58 of the Companies Act of 1956. Next point is, we are moving to preparing offer documents. As part of the issue management procedure, the documents to be prepared are initial listing application for submission to those stock exchanges where the issuing company intends to get its securities listed, MOU with the registrar, with bankers to the issue, with advisors to the issue, and co-managers to the issue, agreement for purchase of properties, etc. This will have to be sent for inclusion in the prospectus. Next, obtaining due diligence certificate. The lead manager issues a due diligence certificate which certifies that the company has scrupulously followed all legal requirements as exercised utmost care while preparing the offer document and has made a true, fair and adequate disclosure in the draft offer document. Eighth one, submission of offer document. The draft offer document along with the due diligence certificate is filed with SEBI. The SEBI in turn makes necessary corrections in the offer document and returns the same with relevant observations, if any, within 20 days from the receipt of the other document. Ninth one, finalization of collection centers. In order to collect the issue application forms from the prospective investors, the lead manager finalizes the collection centers. Tenth one, filing offer document with ROC. The offer document completed in all respects after incorporating SEBI observations is filed with the registrar of companies to obtain acknowledgement. Launching the issue. The process of marketing the issue starts once the legal formalities are completed and statutory permission for issue of capital is obtained. The lead manager has to arrange for the distribution of public issue, stationery to various collecting banks, brokers, investors, etc. The issue is opened for public immediately after obtaining the observation letter from SEBI, which is valid for a period of 365 days from the date of issue. Next point is promoter's contribution. A certificate to the effect that the required contribution of the promoters has been raised before opening the issue has to be obtained from chartered accountant and duly filed with SEBI. Issue closure. An announcement regarding the closure of the issue should be made in the newspapers. This is with the various activities involved in raising funds from the capital markets. Hope it is very clear to you. If any doubts, you can clarify your doubts. Please post it. Thank you. We would meet in the next video with the same related topic. Thank you once again, students.